Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is your boy 50 Shades of Feel coming back to you guys with another video. Today's video is going to focus on none other than my girl Ariana Grande and her new album Eternal Sunshine. Yes, as we know, this is her first concept album based off of the movie Eternal Sunshine with Jim Carrey. If you all know, the 2004 movie is based off that. It is a concept album, but it's also imaginary transitioned into real life. She is talking about her real life experiences, and with this album, I feel like she's coming from a very vulnerable and emotional place, even though this album is boppy. It has a lot of great, oh my God, tracks. But oh my God, she is just literally tearing my head off with this album. Like, all 13 tracks is 1 to 13, guys. It starts with the intro, End of the World, from then on to the last song, which is entitled Ordinary Things, guys. Now, we're going to go into this album track by track, but first I just want to just talk about what I think about this album as a whole. This is one of her best albums, and not to mention she has evolved. When I tell you, she's not the same Ariana Grande we knew back in the early, late, maybe 2011, 2012, back when I didn't know much about her, back when, you know, she's not that same girl. And it shows her evolution throughout every album she comes out with. It shows how she's evolved, how she's grew up, how she's gone through a lot and paved the way for her fans. And this album, to me, really shows that she is really at her best. Musically, vocally, and I love that her voice has actually matured a lot in the songs. When I got into this album yesterday, oh my God, oh my God, I'm just like speechless. Like, do you hear me? She took her damn time, and I'm going to tell you, she took her time with this album, and she did the damn thing. And yes, I really got into it, y'all. I love it. 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 But yes, this album is a concept album, and this is probably one of the first concept albums that she has done. And I love the fact that she did a concept album, because she came back. She was on her four-year hiatus, came back and delivered a masterpiece. Even though this album is, I'm going to tell y'all, very short. I did want a little bit more. I'm not going to lie to you, because the songs are like 2 minutes, 3 minutes. It's not no 4 minute, 5 minute track songs that she would normally have. It's very solid, just like Thank You Next, which is interesting to me because Thank You Next is one of my favorite. Got to give a shout out to that album. That's still one of my favorites. However, this is second to that one, I feel like. And Eternal Sunshine, y'all, we going to get into every song. Let's get into it. That right there is deep. How can she tell that she's in the right relationship? Y'all know that she was recently married. Child, we didn't know much about this guy, but she was recently married, and we don't know if she's referring this to when she was married or if this is her current situation, but this is deep right here. Aren't you really supposed to know that shit? Feel it in your bones and all that shit. She's saying at the end of the world, this is the intro. She's saying basically, if the sun doesn't shine, will you still be there? Will you still hold me? Will you still be with me at the end of the world? She's basically pouring her heart out to this person. And, you know, she's at a very vulnerable place. You can tell by listening to this song, this first intro. The next song starts off, it is called Bye. Y'all, I really, really got into this song. Bye. Oh my God. The disco vibe. I had a great disco vibe that I was feeling. But yes, we finna get into it. Come on, yes. Now, when you think of these song titles, so this is the thing. This is what's so interesting about this album. The song titles seem kind of depressing. And I'm not saying this in a bad way. I'm saying this because the song tracks themselves are completely the opposite of the song title names. This is actually really a uplifting song, even though it's talking about something so sad. Bye. Bye. It's over. It's over. She's saying bye. She kicked his ass to the curb. That's basically what she's saying. That's basically what she is saying. And y'all, I'm just telling y'all, we getting into Ariana Grande, baby. We getting into Ariana. Get into it. The next song is Don't Want to Break Up Again. Now, I'm telling y'all what I love about this song. It gives me literally a 90s nostalgia. It's this skip beat that I love. It's so reminiscent to the 90s. And I'm just getting into the way she is singing. Don't Want to Break Up Again. She's basically saying she's tired of going through this back and forth with this person, and she don't want to keep breaking up. She's just basically saying, like, is it the end, or are we gonna still stay in it? Well, let's get into Don't Want to Break Up Again. Get into it. Hey. Don't ask me how I'm knowing the words to these songs already, y'all. I stayed up till maybe like 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning listening to this album. Since the shit dropped at 11. Yes, y'all. Like, the song title is called Don't Want to Break Up Again, but the music is so soothing and reminiscent, and I love it. We did, after that, we had Saturn Returns interlude. I think that was featuring her Nona, as she called, that's her grandmother. I really, really got into that. That was when the album in general transitioned. Then we get to the song, after Saturn Returns, and you know, it's I think Saturn is on the rise. Like, I feel like this is the universe telling her, you know, to find her eternal sunshine, which is the centerpiece of the album, as she has stated in interviews. Y'all, she really, really breaks it down into Eternal Sunshine, the album track title. Let's get into Eternal Sunshine. And I love it because it's so boppy. Y'all know it? You know we love a bop from Ariana Grande. I mean, the beat is so soothing. It's a typical Ariana Grande bop in an R&B flavor. You know we love when she give us that R&B, because that's when Ariana caught me. When Dangerous Woman came around, and that was when I began to really... Okay, my everything was when I started to get into Ariana Grande, but when Dangerous Woman came out, that was when I began to be a fan. So this, you know, this is just her at her best. Let me get to the end. I just don't want to get to the end. Say, you're just my eternal sunshine. Make me change me. Rewind. Like, she is doing so much with these vocals, with these backgrounds, with this harmonization. She is, like, literally doing a lot on this album that, y'all, oh my God, it's taking my head off every time, each listen. Hold on right quick, bitch, I ain't done. I love it. The next song after that is Supernatural. Now, I'm going to tell y'all what I fucking... Oh, my God. I'm going to try not to curse. Supernatural gives me a 80s nostalgia, y'all, that is so brilliantly put together. This version of Ariana Grande is untouchable. I'm telling you, Supernatural. I mean, she literally saved pop music. I'm just going to say, y'all, this track right here, there's no way you can't say you can't like this song, because just get it to it. It's crystal clear. See, oh my God. I mean, this song is just perfect. You just have to really get into her vocals, her voice, everything. And then when the music comes on, it's over. It's over. I mean, she's basically saying this guy came into her life and it's like supernatural. It catches her like, he's a supernatural being, and she is living for it. She is loving every minute of this man, and she wants him to take control. Don't be afraid to claim me. I mean, she is killing this. She's killing it. And this song is just perfect. It's too damn short, though. Like, these song tracks are like teasers in a way. They're full songs, but they're like teasers. It's just like, it's crazy how short this album is. I mean, the changes, the up-tempo of it is just everything. Oh my God. Then we gonna get into, bitch. True story. Wait a minute. Because I did not expect to get so caught off guard by this song and just, true story. I mean, and y'all, I mean, it's gonna get real serious real quick. I'm telling y'all now, this kind of gives me a little bit of a early or late 1999 vibe, early 2000 vibe. That's kind of nostalgia. I'm telling y'all, what I love about this album is the nostalgia. The greatness of the actual real music that she is bringing back into pop is undeniably amazing. I mean, I don't know what hit her over the head when she was in that studio. That 4-year hiatus did her well. I see what she is talking about when she says in most of her interviews, because she says, and I quote, that when she took away from music, when she had to take a little break from music, she felt, you know, determined again when she came back to it. She felt like she was in a better place with music, whereas 4 or 5 years ago, you know, she was, you know, was used to being that pop queen. But when she took a break and then started doing Wicked, she you know, had to take a break. But when she came back to it, she started falling in love with the art of creating, and, you know, creating art again. So, but baby, we just finna get into true story. This is a true story. Get to it. This is a true story about all the lies you fantasize. Oh my God. I'm telling y'all what I love about this. I might have to turn this up just a little bit. Just a little bit. I'm telling you, this song, you know what, this is a very heartbreaking song, but it's still a bop at the same time, because the way she is coming in with, oh my God, vocally. I just love that. Oh my God, the way she is hitting that, it ain't gonna happen. When she, the way she is, give me love, give me. Oh, when it gets to the end, it's over. It's over. Hell no. Love, 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 love. She said, I will play the villain if you need me to. This is deep. Get into it. And I just got into the music. I said, wait a minute. Boom, 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 boom. Ooh. Get into it, get into it, get into it. Oh, hell no. Sneaking like a creep. Oh, no. Vocally. Oh, hell no. I'm going to have to spend a little bit more time on this song. Wait. True story. What? Come on. Give me love. Come on. Oh. That's my. Yes. Oh my God. I've been so stuck on True Story. I have to get off this song, but True Story. She's basically saying this is a true story of. The back and forth with this person is going nowhere, and it's heartbreaking. It's she's at a horrible space. She's at a horrible space, and she's trying to get. And she's saying, "No, this is not what I want. No, this is not what I need. She needs love, and he's not giving it to her. And give me love." When she hit that, I said, "Oh, girl, no, you didn't." Then. Ari, well done, boo, well done. The next song is The Boy Is Mine. Not. Okay, so there's a lot of backlash about this song because it is a reimagined version, or it's not even similar really to me, but it is a reimagined of the title, The Boy Is Mine, and we know The Boy Is Mine is the original song by Brandy and Monica, the cult classic hit song of the 90s, y'all. One of the most greatest songs ever made from Brandy and Monica. We know that song got huge, did huge numbers back then when I was a little mini me, in like 97, 98. And now Ariana Grande decided to reimagine that song title, but she did it into her own way. So many different people are going to speculate the song and talk about, oh, Ariana Grande's trying to steal this from Brandy and Monica. She should stick to her own stuff. Why is she touching original classics? Blah, 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 blah. She did not say that she was going to. However, I was a little confused at first. When I first seen the song track title, I was like, The Boy Is Mine. I was kind of like, girl, wait a minute, at first. But then I had to think about it. This is not going to be the same version. This is actually her own version. So basically, we know that The Boy Is Mine, The Boy Is Mine, The Boy Is Mine, basically is Monica and Brandy in a situation. They are seeing the same person. And they're both trying to say, no, one's trying to say the boy is mine, the other's trying to say the boy is mine. They both know the same person. They've been with this person, blah, 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 blah. We know the story. But Ariana Grande's version of The Boy Is Mine is cold. And her version of the song is basically she's saying she want to get this boy. And you know when they, you know when she say that she always like to make them bad girl anthems? This is one of them. We know that Ariana Grande... They call her a homewrecker. They want to hate on her. And she got the hate train coming this era. But, you know, people really want to hate her. But how can you deny this girl's talent by calling her a homewrecker? I mean, like, who cares what the girl got going on? Who cares? We are talking about the music. But we are know that she is getting a lot of bad backlash this era with the situation with the ex-husband and blah, 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 blah. We know the situation. However, musically, she's killing us. The Boy Is Mine. This is her version of it, and it's dope. Now, this is Bop Ariana. Now, I'm going to tell y'all what I got about this. This is boom, 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 boom. I like what? Ari. Girl. We went. The boy is my. Baby, the music is on point. And then when she coming with this, the boy. Hey. The boy is my. She said, watch me take eyes. The boy is divine. Boy is. It's too bad I can't play this loud. But oh my God, y'all. When you get into the boy is my. The arrangements, the vocals, the music, everything is on point. She was ready for this song. Baby, this is one of the best ones on here, honestly. However, one of my favorites is And Perfect For You, and that's close to the end of the album, but we almost there. But y'all, oh my God, the boy is my. Now, this is that typical bad girl Ariana Grande. We know she a bad girl. We know she out here in these streets, baby. And this is the Ariana I love. You can call her a homeworker, but the. This song's so damn short, though. It's 2 minutes and 53 seconds. Yeah. I mean, she's saying, like, it's the perfect night. It's the perfect time. Let's get into something. I got my eyes on you. Let me take you. The boy is divine. Get into it. We know Yes And is the bop of the album. The first single of the album. And I love Yes And. I have played it nonstop. I've talked about it. I reviewed it on TikTok. Y'all, the next song after that is We Can't Be Friends. Let me tell y'all something about, this song in general. This is probably the deepest song. She wants to erase the memory that she had with this person. She don't want to be friends with this person. She's just basically saying, wait for your love. And, I really, really got into the story because it's really, really sad. And when I got into the video is actually kind of dedicated to the movie Eternal Sunshine, which we know, is two people trying to erase their memories in a relationship. She kind of did that with this video, and it's really, really kind of sad. She's, you know, telling a story with We Can't Be Friends, Wait For Your Love. Is this my favorite song of the album, though? No, it's not my favorite song on the album. I do think it's a cool song, though. But yes, let's get into Wait For Your Love. Now, it's very poppy. It gives you an 80s vibe. It's that nostalgia. She's still keeping that same nostalgia as she's doing throughout the whole entire album. Yes. Now, this typically is not my personal favorite. I do think it's a cute song, but it's a very sad song. In my opinion, this is probably one of the saddest songs. I Wish I Hated You was probably one of the saddest songs, too. But this is the vulnerable part of the album where, you know, she's pouring her heart out and she just wants to erase all of the memories that she's had with this person. The next song is I Wish I Hated You. Now, this song is a tearjerker it's very sad, and it's actually a cappella. One of the things I did kind of like about this song was the pureness of her voice. Get into it. In the closet you made, your shoes still in boxes, I send them your way. I mean, she collected all his stuff. She's collecting all of his belongings, and she's going to ship it to him. She don't want to see him. She just want out. And this, to me, I feel for her because she sounds so sad on the song. But there is bits and elements about the song that I do like. I love how she did that. Let me rewind it one more time. Oh my God. She, like, I'm telling y'all, vocally, she killed this album. And, you know, I love that her voice has matured in a way, too, because she's actually expressing and showing different ways of, displaying her voice on the tracks. And, you know. You know, I Wish I Hated You as a tearjerker. Yes, but then we get into another song that's kind of sad, but a bop at the same time, and it became my favorite damn song on the album, and Perfect For You. I'm telling you, I effing love this song. Like, love it. I love this song. When I got into it, I'm like, okay, I didn't know what to expect from it. But when I got into it and when that beat dropped, I fell in love with this song because get into it and Perfect For You. Let's get into it. And she starts off so, you know, it's something about this. It kind of gives you a country vibe in a way, and it kind of gives you just, it just gives you a vibe of where she's going, and you can tell she's getting ready to tell you a deep story and Perfect For You. But when the beat dropped, it was over. I mean, from start to damn finish. I mean, I love it. Crash and we burn. Now I just can't go where you don't go. Wow. Oh my God. Me too. Am perfect for you. Yes! This song caught me completely off guard because I didn't know which direction she was going to go, but I immediately fell in love with this song. The vibe of it, the tone of it, even though it's kind of sad, it's still a bop at the same time. And I get why now Ariana Grande chose this as one of her personal top three songs. I think the fans get it now because... and Perfect For You, she's imperfect for this person, but she wants to still be with this person. But it's a lot that we know that in relationships, things are imperfect. No relationship, no person, the people that we choose to be with are not perfect. Everybody has a fault. But she's saying she wants to be imperfect for this person, you know, maybe it'll come to some type of common ground, you know, they crash, they burn, you know, they paved the way, they tried to stay with one another, they tried to build a castle together, they tried to build a family, but it began to be a disaster, it became to be disastrous at times, and Perfect For You. I just love Imperfect For You. I just love it. It's so beautiful. All right, girl. And this to me was very different from, this was not a typical Ariana Grande song. It was something different about the way she did her voice on the song, the way her vocals, gravitated to the music, and she did a lot of different things with this song. This sounded completely different from anything she's ever made. This is probably one of her best songs too. I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm telling you, the moment I heard it, I played it over and over and over. The last song is Ordinary Things, which is the last song of the album. It's featuring her Nona, her grandmother, and y'all, my God, wow. Eternal Sunshine is just, y'all, I really, really got into this album, the creativity, her headspace of where she is emotionally. Let's get into it. Let's get into Ordinary Things. I like, for one, how the horns came on in the beginning. Let's get into it. I mean, and she's kind of like taking you to this, like, this journey of... I mean, the way she riding that beat with the vocals is just amazing. I mean, vocally, musically, sonically, this is one of her best albums. And when she hit that note, oh my God, I felt it. I felt this. The now this could be her possible current relationship. We don't know. She could be reflecting on a memory. She could be reflecting on someone else's memory, or she could be reflecting on something that she's going through in this recent state of mind or recent situation. So what she's going through, but she's saying that. It's not going to be an ordinary thing. It's going to come natural. She's basically saying, like, with this person, she's like, we can do whatever. We can skip away out the country. We could do whatever we want to do. We could be happy. We could be married. We could be free. And it's not going to be an ordinary thing with us. It's just going to be that typical. It's going to be that love. It's going to be Ordinary Things. I got into it. And then I think her Nona was basically talking about a memory of who she was with at the end. Her grandmother. We know that lots of times she liked to put her Nona. And she kind of did this with. This is what kind of reminds me of Thank You Next, because she kind of did the same thing. She had a lot of her stuff, a lot of the small little clips with her grandmother in there. So she kind of did the same thing with this album, and I like that. But musically, vocally, this album, Eternal Sunshine, oh my God. If you don't get with the program, you just don't get with the program. But this is one of her best ones. I'm going to have to say it's second to Thank You Next. And Thank You Next is still one of my favorites. However, this one is just as good. Because this shows how she has evolved musically. She is not in the same headspace she was 6-7 years ago or 5 years ago. The Thank You Next times. We know that Thank You Next, when she was coming out of her shell and she was doing a lot more bad girl anthems. This one, she's still kind of that same Ari, but not the same Ari. She's a more evolved Ari. She's more... she's trying to find the eternal sunshine within herself. She's getting over a heartbreak. It's hard. She's not perfect, but they want to hate on this girl. They say this is the break. This is the heartbreak season of Ariana Grande. This is her being a homewrecker. This is homewrecker era. But I live for it. I live for Ariana. I love her. Huge fan. Girl, drop them tour dates. That's all. Drop the tour dates. I'm waiting for my CD to come in the mail. And then we're going to purchase that vinyl. But yes, this is your boy 50 Shades of Feel. Get into it.